Hello friends, Brahmesh Panikkar. On behalf of KNA, we are discussing electrochemistry. So we were discussing Nernst equation. This is E cell equal to E0 cell minus 2.303 RT upon NF. Anodic concentration log of log base 10, anodic concentration upon cathodic concentration. So if the cell is given, this is also called voltaic cell, alright, electrochemical cell. So here the concentrations are now different and we are changing the temperature. Now, as far as this E0 cell is concerned, this is we have discussed. E0 cell is given by E0 of cathode minus E0 of anode. Alright. E0 cathode minus E0 of anode. So this is standard value. Now we are looking at the effect of concentration and temperature. So this is the relation. Alright. And like in a cell, I told you at right hand side you will be given cathode and at left hand side you will be given anode. So this is if it is negative sign, you should be careful. If it is negative sign, anodic concentration, which is anode, zinc. So this concentration you have to put here, that is 0.1, and here you will put 0.01. Whereas if you use positive sign, then it is opposite, cathodic concentration upon anodic concentration. So you should be careful. So how EMF of a cell can be increased? If you want to increase the EMF, now N is the number of electrons getting transferred, so this you cannot change. Faraday is constant, R is constant. You can increase the temperature. If you increase the temperature, EMF will increase. E cell will increase with the increase in temperature. This is one statement you get. And the second statement is, if you increase cathodic concentration, if you increase cathodic concentration or if you decrease anodic concentration, the EMF will increase, E cell will increase. So these are the factors by which you can increase EMF of a cell. Alright, so normally the question is asked. Now, if you solve this much portion, 2.303 RT upon F at 298 Kelvin, at 298 Kelvin, you will find E cell is equal to E0 cell plus 0.059 upon N log of cathodic concentration, like we are taking copper 2 positive and zinc. Always remember, zinc copper couple, always it is better to remember that zinc is on left hand side, right, copper is on right hand side. Or you can remember that zinc is basically anode and copper is cathode, and copper we put at the numerator position and zinc at denominator position, provided it is positive. That's it. So you can compare when any other cell is given, you can compare where did you put copper and zinc and what was the sign, like that. All right and if you want to solve the numericals lesser calculation, 0.059 can be taken 0.06. so in this case, for zinc copper couple, we already discussed the EMF of cell is 1.1 plus 0.06 divided by 2. That is so that you can compare on the basis of positive charge. All right and then log base 10, copper 2 positive concentration is 10 raised to power minus 3, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3 upon 10 raised to power minus 1. So we are left with 10 raised to power minus 2, and 10 raised to power minus 2 means it becomes minus 2. This is gone. So we are left with 1.1 plus this value, that is 0.06. All right, minus 0.06, plus minus minus, it becomes minus 1.1 minus 0.06. That means by increasing anodic concentration, if anodic concentration is more than cathodic concentration, EMF of cell is decreased. All right. And for this couple, like aluminium, see, look at now this case, aluminium oblique aluminium 3 positive, concentration is given, suppose concentration is 0.01, and this indicates the salt bridge. All right then copper 2 positive, this is 1 molar suppose, and then copper, So first thing, in such cases you have to balance the reaction, that is aluminium plus copper 2 positive, and here you will write Al3 positive, because in anode oxidation takes place and in cathode reduction takes place. Copper 2 positive will be converted to copper. So to balance the charge, you have to put thrice of copper 2 positive, and this is twice of Al3 positive. And regarding N is equal to 6, N becomes 6. So E cell is equal to E0 cell. For E0 cell, you will be given E0 values. Like I know E0 of aluminium is minus 1.66 and E0 of copper is plus 0.34. So if you solve this value, you get 2. All right, E0 cell plus, I'm taking positive sign, 0.059 by 2 log of, now see, copper is at right hand side, and for copper, what is the stoichiometric coefficient? 3. So copper 2 positive, the cube, upon this is Al3 positive, and what is the stoichiometric coefficient? It is 2. Al3 positive square, like that. So this is a 2 plus 0.06, you can take 2 log of, copper concentration is 1 molar, so you can ignore, and this is 10 raised to power minus 2 the square, so 10 raised to power minus 4, or it goes at numerator 10 raised to power 4 is log 10 is 1, log 100 is 2, log 1000 is 3, and log 10,000 is 4. So 4, this portion is 4, this is cancelled 2, so 0.12, so you get 2.12. all right, this is 2.12 volt. All right, so in this manner you can calculate EMF, etc. All right, and for a half cell you will find, like, twice of H positive plus twice of electron equal to H2. E is equal to E electrode. We are talking about electrode now. E0 of hydrogen plus, again you are taking 0.05, and temperature is 25 degrees Celsius, means 298 Kelvin. Normally large calculations will not be there. Upon N log of, since it is positive sign, we take reactant upon product, that is H positive the square upon pressure of hydrogen. See, so you will find questions like E of hydrogen at say pH 10. This is a common question, very common question. So E0 of hydrogen is 0, so E equal to 0.059 upon 2, because 2 electrons are getting transferred, log of, since pH is 10, you can say H positive concentration is 1 exponential minus 10, so it is 10 raised to power minus 10 the square upon pressure of hydrogen. In electrode potential, means in hydrogen electrode, we take hydrogen at 1 bar pressure, so it is 1. May change, means they can ask question like different questions where pressure is different. So this is 10 raised to power minus 20, so this is 0.059 upon 2 into log of 10 raised to power minus 20 is minus 20, so it is minus 10, or it is minus 0.59 volt, negative minus 0.59 volt, like that. So you will find these kind of questions. All right, so in electrode potential, in electrochemical cells, you will find these kind of questions, numericals. Okay, they can ask concentration cells as well, like same the anode and cathode will be made of same electrode. All right, like Zn, Zn2 positive, this is C1 concentration, this is anode, so you must know. And then this is the salt bridge, and then again Zn2 positive, and this is C2 concentration, and this is zinc. So again, E equal to E0 becomes 0, E0 plus 0.059 upon N. log of now, which is cathode. This is cathode. So C2 by C1. So E0 is gone. It is 0.059 upon 2 log of C2 by C1. So the point is, if C2 is greater than C1, obviously then only E cell will be positive and cell will be spontaneous. All right. So these kind of questions may be there. And then comes the conduction part. And conduction, we discuss about electrolytic conduction means the conduction which is means due to movement of ions. All right, electrolytic conduction. So conduction, we can discuss equivalent conductance. This is denoted by lambda eq. This is the conductance of conductance by all the ions of 1 gram equivalent of a substance. Like if you dissolve 58.5 grams of NaCl, so you will find 1 gram ion of Na positive and 1 gram ion of Cl negative. Means Avogadro number of Na positive and Cl negative. The total conductance is called equivalent conductance. This is equivalent mass. Whereas for calcium chloride, you should be careful. Equivalent mass of calcium 20 plus equivalent mass of chlorine is 35.5. So it is 55.5, the conductance of 1 gram equivalent of a substance. Whereas if you talk about molar conductance, this is denoted by lambda m. The molar mass of calcium chloride is 111 grams. All right. So molar conductance of calcium chloride, if you want to write, it is the conductance of calcium 2 positive plus conductance twice of conductance of Cl negative. Means this is the conductance of 40 gram and 2 into 35.5 gram. So this is 71 gram plus 40 gram, that is equal to 111 gram. Conductance of 111 grams of calcium chloride. All right, in which we have 1 gram ion of calcium and 2 gram ions of Cl negative. The total conductance is called molar conductance. Whereas if you want to write equivalent conductance of calcium chloride, it is the conductance of half of calcium, means 40 gram divided by 2, 20 grams calcium's conductance plus conductance of Cl negative. That is, say, this is the standard values, means at infinite dilution we are writing. Alright. So, this is 35.5. The sum of these two is 55.5 gram. So, see, conductance of 111 gram is molar conductance, and conductance of 55.5, that is equivalent mass, is called equivalent conductance. The relation is molar conductance equal to Z into equivalent conductance. So for NaCl, for NaC, Z is the total positive and or total negative charge. So for NaCl, you can say lambda m of NaCl is equal to lambda eq of NaCl. Both are same. Whereas for CaCl2, lambda m of CaCl2 is twice the lambda eq of CaCl2, like that. And if you want to write molar conductance of Al2SO4 whole thrice, it will be written equivalent conductance of Al3 positive total, that is twice, so twice of, plus thrice of SO42 negative conductance of this. This is called molar conductance. Whereas if you want to write equivalent conductance of aluminium sulfate, it will be written 1/3 of Al3 positive, means 9 gram conductance of 9 grams of Al plus conductance of half of conductance of SO42 negative, means 48 grams conductance. This is 9 gram plus 48 gram, that is equal to 57 gram. This is the equivalent mass of aluminium sulfate. All right, and equivalent mass into 6 will be molar mass. This is 57 gram into 6. This is the molar conductance. This is equivalent conductance. All right. So this was it, and one more thing, that is the molar conductance or equivalent conductance is directly proportional to dilution. Means if we are given 0.1 molar, 0.01 molar, 0.001 molar, KCl solutions are given, and which shows the highest molar conductance, you can say this one shows highest molar conductance. Whereas as far as specific conductance is concerned, specific conductance is inversely proportional to dilution. In that case, the specific conductance of this is maximum. All right. So in this manner, you can solve some questions regarding equivalent conductance and etc. And there is a relation, equivalent conductance equal to K into 1000 upon normality, or molar conductance equal to K into 1000 upon molarity. And for a saturated solution, this molarity becomes solubility. So they may ask about solubility. This is solubility in moles per liter. All right. If it is a saturated solution. And the unit is also important, that is mu centimeter square per gram equivalent, or for molar conductance it is mu centimeter square per gram mole. All right, this is also important. So all the best for tomorrow's exam. Thank you.